When I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a waving flag.
You already know what it is, baby. B96, we are hip-hop. Your boy's in the building. Pete Parker holding it down, my guy. Yo, Kanan? Are you kidding me right now, sir?
What up?
Yo, Somalia is in the building.
That's
like,
the stuff.
Toronto is on the inside right now?
Yeah.
Yo, how does it feel to be a cat, like, one of the first, like, I've seen a lot of artists come and go, a lot of different nationalities, a lot of different heritage. You see Italian rappers, Irish rappers, you see singers. To be a Somalian cat representing Somalia, being in Minnesota, knowing how many Somalian people are here.
Boom.
Boom. This is you right here. This is your town, man.
Yeah, yo. And I actually used to live here as well.
Shut up.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, I lived here for a bit. It was like where I first kind of started really writing.
Wow.
So I got a real connection to this place, man.
That's what it is, though. I mean, yo, a lot of people are comparing you, saying this kid is like a Somalian Wyclef. He got a little Mos Def in him.
Yeah,
you know what I mean? A lot of Bob Marley.
Yeah.
Your flow is Eminem crazy.
Yeah.
Did Michael Jackson influence you?
Michael basically influenced everybody, I think. You know what I mean?
How did it affect you, though? You know what I mean?
Just kind of like, I just remember people telling me I look like him a little bit when Mike was, you know what I mean? Mike was younger.
Young Mike, yeah.
Used to do the Afro thing. So I kind of was like trying to a little bit look like him as well.
You got it going with it? You know what I mean?
I got it. But we were playing Idaho, like in Boise, Idaho. And when the thing happened, when he passed away, and the suddenness of like, Mike has passed away.
Crazy. It's like,
I just never thought, because for me, I'm like, I love Mike like everybody else love Mike.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I wasn't a particular Mike fan.
Like a diehard.
Like that guy. Yeah, I wasn't that dude. But I had a physical reaction to it, man. I just couldn't believe, like, I felt like I was a bit suspended. I didn't know how I could play the show that night.
Yeah.
Like, it really affected me.
Yo, dog, we were talking about it all week. I've been talking about it all day yesterday. I watched the funeral on repeat 17 times in a row.
Yeah.
It shut the whole planet down.
It's wild, man.
And being a musician, an artist, and how much you give to people, how many people you touch.
Yeah.
To see a guy who touched the world and the most donations, it's got to be inspiring.
It is, and it just shows you how, like, you know what I mean, no one is invisible. It's a beautiful feeling to know that we all go, you know what I mean? And like, you know what I mean? And that, you know, for me, though, I just had to figure out that particular night, like, what to do about it. And I know a lot of people, artists, were doing tributes that night or whatever.
Yeah.
What I did is, after I finished the show, we closed with Waving Flag.
Yeah.
And then you had the whole crowd singing this, like, you know what I mean, this song, this anthemic feeling was in the, and then I just said, all right, thank you for having us tonight. Mike passed away. I want to play some of his music. So we just played it on the house speakers.
Right.
And my whole band went into the crowd and we danced with him.
It's a magical feeling to hear these records again.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Can we play Waving Flag right now? Can I go in?
Please do.
When I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a waving flag. When I get older, I will be stronger.